So some stereotypes you most commonly hear about scientists is that scientists are white men in lab coats pouring potions.
Lab, white lab coat, goggles, safety goggles.
Very sterile white lab coat in a clean lab.
People that are introverted, not very outgoing, kind of dense.
They work independently. They're loners. They don't have good social skills.
Don't know how to talk to people. Don't know how to interact. Don't know what emotions are.
That they have to be serious all the time.
Pocket protector, glasses, nerdy.
Really, really smart and have to be the smartest person in the room.
Geniuses.
Geniuses. They are atheists, you know, are very narrowly focused on their science.
So one of the things that people always assume is that scientists are kind of weird and kind of geeky. And I feel like maybe that is sort of what I'm like. I mean, I've been collecting rocks forever and specimen and bugs and putting them in jars.
Some of the stereotypical traits of a scientist that I identify with are just true nerdism.
But like, what's a nerd, you know? Is a nerd somebody who likes to read a lot? Guilty.
I've definitely been called nerdy by people, and I have like some weird interests.
When I go to the beach or when I go around, I tend to observe kind of random things and then think about them a lot.
You know, my family always says that line from Beauty and the Beast where Belle says, "Father, am I odd?" And he comes out from under his contraption and he says, "Now where'd you get an idea like that?" And his bifocals are all big and his eyes are all big. That's how I kind of feel, and that's what my family always says when they're talking about me.
I do enjoy my own company, so I guess I'm a bit of an introvert, which is sort of a stereotypical scientist trait. Things that are false are that I don't like to socialize at all, and I think the stereotype that scientists don't play sports or enjoy other hobbies are definitely false. About me, I have a lot of hobbies.
The way you learn about science as a kid is you learn about the people who have made like, you know, big contributions, right? You learn about Gregor Mendel and Isaac Newton. You think if you aren't that, then you're not a real scientist. And I think that really challenged me as I was developing as a scientist because, you know, I don't fit that mold.
I think I was often sort of under the impression that science had to be everything in your life. That if you were going to be a scientist, that this was going to be everything for you.
Yeah, to be honest, it's always this image of a very, like, single-minded individual.
And not necessarily that they have to look a certain way, but they have to behave a certain way. And sometimes that would make me question whether or not I was cut out to be a scientist, because I'm a pretty outgoing person. And in my mind, I thought all scientists had to be at work all the time.
And that didn't feel right for me, right? Like, I like art, I like history. I don't think that those sort of stereotypes that science had to be your whole life made me believe that I couldn't be a scientist, but I think it made me believe that I didn't want to be a scientist.
My ideas about what had to be innately true about a scientist definitely made it so that it took me a lot longer to consider science as a career. I think if I would have identified myself as a, you know, as having traits of a scientist, I might have come to science a little earlier.
I have been told that I do not look like a scientist by random people. I don't look like a scientist because I am a woman, because I am small, because I am silly, because I'm outgoing, because I'm personable.
You can't be a scientist, you're too smiley. But clearly that's not true, because I am a scientist who smiles a lot.
You know what? I am a scientist.
There are a lot of stereotypes that may or may not fit, but I think being curious.
Curious?
Curious?
Curiosity.
Curiosity.
Asking a lot of questions.
I do like to ask a lot of questions.
Persistence and perseverance.
Devotion.
Definitely interesting.
A lot of them are very fun, creative people.
Scientists are creative. You can be smart, you can learn all the things in a book and get straight A's, but scientists are able to take that information, to take that knowledge and turn it into something new. So they're able to use their creativity to explore the world in different ways and learn new things.
Thanks a lot for watching. Please support what we're doing. We have a lot of passionate scientists that are on board to share their knowledge and insights and their stories of how they got to where they are and how to succeed in this field and why it's so important, why science is so important. You can help us tremendously for free by sharing these videos, subscribing, and getting the word out. You can also help us not for free by chipping in a dollar or two on our Patreon account. So please support us. We'll continue to produce these videos. We do this for free. We do this because we care. So we're happy that you're watching. Thank you.